With three major laboratories on board, that includes the U.S. laboratory Destiny, this Japanese laboratory Kibo, and also the Columbus laboratory of the European Space Agency. A number of experiments are always ongoing aboard the station, even when the crew is not required to interact with those experiments. A lot of the experiments can be conducted, and the crew perform status checks periodically. In addition to the burning and suppression of solids experiment, there's also additional experiment that to test how flames are extinguished in space.
I like to call it hot research. It's the Flame Extinguishment Experiment, or FLEX, and crew members have been working on this experiment in recent weeks. I had the opportunity to talk to one of the investigators about why and how they study flames in space.
Basically, we're trying to understand how we can be safer in space by understanding when flames burn and the conditions where flames go out. We're looking for that boundary position where one moment your flame is alive and the next moment your flame is extinguished. And so we've been taking a look at different fuels and different conditions in the chamber, different atmospheric pressures, different suppressants, and we're looking for those places where the flame goes out and why.
Flames act a lot differently in space, right?
Absolutely. In space, we've learned that the fires burn at a slower burning rate, that they burn at a lower temperature, but they burn at a lower oxygen concentration, which makes them a little bit more dangerous for crew. You might put your hand on a panel and you might not feel the fire. It's harder to detect fires in space because the lack of gravity means there's no buoyancy. There's no reason for the flames to send smoke up across the ceiling like they do on Earth. So it's harder for a smoke detector to detect the fires, and because it burns at a lower oxygen concentration, it allows fires to continue to burn after maybe you think you've put them out.
Wow. So how do crew members handle flames in space?
Well, we do have some space-based smoke detectors, which have been redesigned through our research to look at larger soot particles, because soot tends to grow larger in space. We have more detectors behind various panels, and we have different kinds of suppressants, but those are the things we're still studying to try to find the most effective ways of putting out the fires.
So it obviously has space applications, but what about for folks here on Earth?
Our research also extends to some fundamental research and allows us to take a look at our computer models and our equations. And we're going to, by operating in space, take gravity out of the equation, and which makes our equations simpler, our computer models are simpler, and it allows us to then use those models for redesigning furnaces and engines and combustors on Earth to be more efficient, to allow us to use less fuel, create less greenhouse gases and less soot, and basically create a greener planet.